Hi everyone, today we are going to be making this lovely cell phone case. This one has a pretty flower on the back and a button closure, and it has a secret pocket in the front for your credit cards and ID and cash, anything like that, and then your cell phone pocket is in the back there. You know, if you're going out and about, if you're just running to the store real quick and you don't want to take your whole purse or something, you could grab something like this. Just put a little bit of cash in there and your cell phone and be on your way. Or if you're going out to the beach, or if you're going, you know, somewhere with friends or a concert or something like that and you don't want to carry around a big purse, you could just carry this with you. It could fit in your pocket even, and that will have your credit cards all secure with this flap closure like that, so your cards won't be falling out. You know, you can shake it around and move it upside down and it's not going to go anywhere. And then there's this cute little flower on the back to just embellish it a little bit. So you can even put a little jewel there if you wanted to. But anyway, I will show you all the supplies and then we can get into this. So I'm using Red Heart Yarns. That is I don't have a label with me. Here's something similar. I'll just show this label. So it is a medium 4 yarn and Red Heart. You can use With Love, you can use Super Saver, you can use any type of Red Heart yarn. This is a great scrap project. There's not much yarn included, you know, required for this piece, so you can do a scrap buster basically and just crochet using scrap yarns. And this is 10 ply yarn, so if you don't have Red Heart yarn where you live, you can get 10 ply yarn anywhere. And let's see here, I just, like I said, use scrap yarn, so you don't even need to know how much yarn I used because it's just scraps. And I used a wooden button here, but you can use any size or any type of button you have. And in the video I share how to make a bigger buttonhole closure. My buttonhole is a little bit small, so I show how to make a bigger one or a smaller one if you have a smaller button. And so in my colors that I used, this blue main color is Jade. This pink outline is Shocking Pink. This outline of this flower is Aran. This inside orange is Carrot. And this inside is Dark Time, or Medium Time, it's called. So I will have all those colors in the description of this video. Make sure to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and join our Facebook so you can see others' crochet work. And also, you know, make sure to see the links in the description. You can get the pattern for this and also my website so you can see all my crochet videos. So for the main part of this cell phone bag or the cell phone case, we are going to be using an H size hook, which is 5 millimeters. And then for the flower in the back, we are using a G size hook, which is 4.25 millimeters. So the G size hook is for the flower, and the H size hook is for everything else. So for the pocket, for the cell phone case, for this flap, everything. But the G size hook is only for the flower. And then you also obviously need a scissors and a tapestry needle. So I have that here just for sewing and everything. So you want to use one of these. And that should do it. So if you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comments section below and I will get back to you. Otherwise, enjoy making this and let's get started. All right, so to start off, we are going to make a slip knot. So put the short end over the long end and then fold that over and pull that through. Okay, if that was too fast for you, we can, you know, you can rewind this, or there are other videos out there to show you how to do a slip knot. Now, we have to make it to fit my cell phone. So, or your cell phone. My cell phone is about 4 3/4 long and 2.5 inches wide. So we are working from the bottom up, so I'm going to need to make a chain that is 2.5 inches long. Now your phone may be bigger or smaller depending on which style phone you have. I have a Moto X, so mine is 2.5 inches. If you have, you know, different style or different size, you may have to chain just a few extra. So to chain, whoopsie, let me get that back on there. I'll move this up. All right, so to chain, you yarn over and pull through. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm gonna measure and see if that's long enough. Oh yes, it looks like it's long enough. So I'm going to stick with 10 chains. Now you want to chain one more, just extra. So whatever your chain is, and then plus one. So my chain is 10. So I am going to chain one more for 11. And I'll explain that in a second. So mine is 10 chains. Yours may be, you know, a little bit longer or so, but I think that's a good amount. And that's a little stretchy too, so that'll give it enough room to breathe in there so it won't get hot or anything. So I had to chain 11 because we are not working in this first chain. We have to start crocheting in the second chain from the hook. So the loop that's on the hook never counts as anything. So we're gonna count one and then two, and we're gonna work in this chain here. And what I usually like to do too is work in the back loops. So you see your chain like this, and you can see these look like little V's here, and we would normally go in front to this top loop here, but I'm actually going to turn my chain toward me like this and work in these back ridges. You can see here, so right here, right here, right here, and so on. So we're working in those back ridges. So skip the first chain and go straight to the second one and insert your hook. Then yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two. Okay, we are going to be putting another single crochet in that same chain. Okay, so we put two single crochet in the first chain, or in the second chain from the hook. Now across, we are going to work one single crochet in each chain across until we hit the last chain. So just continue working one single crochet in each chain, just like this. So insert your hook in the chain, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two. Okay, till you get to the very last one, and we're gonna put three single crochet in that last chain. Okay, so I come up on my last chain here. So put three single crochet in there. Oops. Yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two. There's one, there's two, and there's three. And notice how I'm turning my work. So now I'm turning it upside down like this. So I'm looking at the bottom. Still, this is our chain. So we were working like this across here, and now we put three in the last stitch here. So now we're turning, and now we're going to work along this edge. Okay, and I'm going to crochet over the top of my straggler, so you can see me do that. But now we put three in here, so now it looks like we need to put a stitch in here for the first stitch, but we are not doing that because we just put three in there. So skipping this first part right here, we're going directly into the next one right here, okay? Because we just put, it looks like we missed this one, but actually we put three in there already. So we're going to this next one here and just single crocheting across, okay? And once we get to the beginning, we're just going to put one single crochet in there because we put two starting off. I hope that makes sense. We put two in, you know, in the beginning, the very first stitch we did. So now we don't have to put three in that last one. And I'll show you when I get there. So I'm just putting one single crochet all the way across. Okay, so my straggler is all secure. I can drop that. And that was the last stitch there. So now you can see here, we put stitch one and two in there. We're just gonna put one more for three. So now we have crocheted all the way around this piece. And you can either decide at this point, you can slip stitch to this beginning point, or you can just continue crocheting in a spiral. I am going to connect. So insert your hook, pull through, like yarn over and pull through, and then pull through. So that is a slip stitch. Okay, let me cut my straggler. Get that out of the way. There we go. Okay, so this is the bottom of our cell phone case, like that. So now just chain up one, and now rounds two through five, we are just continuing to single crochet around. No more increasing, no more putting more than one single crochet in each stitch. Just put one single crochet in each stitch all the way around, just like this. Just insert your hook, yarn over, pull through two, and then go into the next stitch for another single crochet. So we're just single crocheting all the way around for rounds two through five, just like this. And then after round five, we will be getting into the actual pattern. But we just want our base to be a solid base. So, you know what? Actually, this seems like it's going to be big enough. You know what? Do two and three. Don't do round two to five. Just do rounds two and three like this. I've just changed my mind and decided. I mean, you can do that, but let's see here. Okay, I'm back to the beginning now. So just slip stitch, insert your hook into the first stitch, yarn over, pull through, and through. Yeah. So you can do rounds two through five like this, but I'm just going to do this next round. So rounds two and three, I'm just doing the single crochet. And then on round four is when I'm going to actually get into my pattern. And there's going to be some texture on that. So let me get there and I'll meet you up to go on to round four.
Okay.
All right, I do want to mention one thing. When you come back around, it may look like you are coming up on a stitch right here, but in fact, that is our slip stitch, and then this is our chain one, and then this is our first single crochet. So do not crochet in this or in this. We are going to crochet or slip stitch into here. So that's when you come back around. So just keep that in mind that you're not trying to insert your hook in here. It is going to be tight and then you're going to be like, oh, that's my slip stitch. And then you're going to try and get your hook into here and that's your chain one. So obviously your hook isn't going to fit in there. But then you insert your hook in here and there you go. That's our first single crochet. We are slip stitching into there. So that's just a little tip and trick I just wanted to share with you. So now this is how it looks. So you can even see, I mean, our phone will probably fit in there. Haha, look at how cool that looks. There. So our phone fits in there so far. So now is our pattern. So we are going to chain up two, and this is round four. So chain up two and do a half double crochet in that first stitch that we just chained up two in. So this chain up two is not going to count as a stitch, so please do not crochet with that. Just gets us up to our height that we need. So yarn over, insert your hook in that same space, then yarn over and pull through. So you have three loops on your hook, then yarn over and pull through all three loops. Okay, that's a half double crochet. Now, so that's basically, we just went into this stitch. Now for the next stitch, we are going to be Actually, maybe we should do that all the way around. So let's do one half double crochet in each stitch around. Okay, so we just yarned over, went in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all three loops. That's another half double crochet. So yep, half double crochet all the way around for round four, just like this, in each stitch. Okay, this is just a baseline for the pattern that we are going to do. Remember I said we are going to make texture in this piece to make it more of a 3D look. So just keep that in mind. We're just doing a half double crochet in each stitch around. I'll meet you back up when I'm at the beginning to go on to round five.
Okay.
All right, so now I'm back to the beginning. Do not slip stitch in this chain two space, or this chain two. Just slip stitch into the first stitch, the first half double crochet of that round. Okay? Going on to round five, we're going to chain up two, one and two. And now we're going to work around our half double crochets. Okay? So we're going to do on this this first stitch right here, we're going to do a front post half double crochet. So what I did is just yarn over, go in from the side of the post, okay, so not in the stitch like this, go into the side of the post and then out to the front like this, so around that, then yarn over and pull that through, and then yarn over and pull through all three loops on your hook. Okay, that's a front post half double crochet. Now in this next stitch, we are just going to simply half double crochet into the stitch. So not around anything, just into the stitch. Like that. Okay? Then around the next one, we're going to do a front post half double crochet again. Okay? Then around the next one, we are just going to do a regular half double crochet in the stitch. Okay, then on around the next one we are going to do our front post half double crochet, so go around the post like that. Okay, then the next one we're working into the stitch up here and doing a half double crochet. So every other one we are going to be putting a half double crochet, a front post half double crochet, and every other one we're putting just a regular half double crochet. Okay? Just like that. So don't, make sure you're not skipping any stitches or any posts. Okay, so this one I just did was a front post, so this one definitely has to be a regular stitch. Okay, and then this one is definitely a front post. So just like that. So just work that all the way around, and I'll meet you back up when I have done that. All right, so I'm back to the beginning. Now you want to make sure you slip stitch to the first stitch, which is our front post half double crochet here. Do not slip stitch into the chain two, okay? So slip stitch right there. Chain up two, one and two, and now in the stitches that we worked our front post half double crochet, we are going to work a regular stitch into those. Okay, so work a regular half double crochet stitch in this first stitch that we just chained up two in. We're working a regular half double crochet like that. Okay, now in this stitch that's just a regular stitch from the previous round, we're going to work a front post half double crochet around that one. Okay, so every other row is opposite. See, now this stitch is a front post, so we are going to work a regular stitch into that, a regular half double crochet into that stitch. Then this next one here is a regular stitch, so we're going to work our front post half double crochet around that one. Okay, then this next one here, regular stitch, a regular half double crochet like that. And then the next one is a front post. Okay, so you kind of get that idea. So just work your stitches just like that. And again, make sure you're not skipping any or, you know, doing two in a row or anything like that, because that could take your pattern a little bit off. So just continue working this pattern. I'll meet you back up when we'll go on to the next round. And I believe that's round 7. Yep. So we're working on round 6 right now. And I'll show you how to go on to round 7. And then I'll leave you to do the pattern. All right, coming back to the beginning, we are just going to slip stitch again to the first stitch. Okay, so make sure it's not the chain 2. It's this first stitch here. Okay, so pull through and pull through. There. So now we're going on to round 7, but let me pause for a second and show you. This is how my phone is going to fit in there. Okay, so this pattern is very versatile. You could use it, again, like I said earlier, for any size phone. And I love the dimension this gives. It's a really cool stitch. So let's continue our pattern. Now, this is our repeat pattern. We're just going to repeat what we did for row 5. So chain up 2, 1 and 2. And now, since this first stitch was a regular half double crochet, we are going to put a half front post half double crochet around it. Okay, so by this point, I think you know how to do a front post half double crochet. So do a front post half double crochet around that one, then you go to this next one here, and that is, let's see here, right here. So, you know, it's kind of confusing, which stitch do you stitch in, this one or this one? It is going to be this one. And sometimes you may crochet into this one, that's totally fine, but it is this one. So you have to really find out by pulling this forward, looking at the stitch that you just crocheted around, that's that one, so you have to work into this one next to it. So we're working a regular half double crochet into there. Yarn over first, then go into the stitch, yarn over, pull through, and yarn over and pull through all three. Okay, then this next stitch, so we don't work around this one, we're going to this one right here. We are going to put our front post half double crochet. Okay, then this next stitch, just a regular half double crochet. Then this next one is a front post. Okay, and once you start working on this and getting used to it, you will know which ones need to be regular half double crochets and which ones need to be the front post half double crochets. So you'll know once you start working on this for a while. And that's it. That's the repeat pattern. So just repeat this round, and, you know, rounds 6 and 7, or, you know, rows 5 and 6, I guess, for the whole thing. You know, just, you know, if it's a front post, you have to do a regular. If it's a regular stitch, you have to do a front post. So we're just working on the stitches from the previous round. So whatever those ones are, you're gonna do the opposite. Okay, so just repeat this round for however long you need yours to be. Like I said, mine needs to be 4¾ inch tall. So I'm going to do that, and I'll meet you up when I have done that.
Okay.
All right, now that I've made it to be the size I need, the length I need it to be, you can pause and put your phone in and make sure that it does fit. And mine does. And there's still room inside. Okay, like that. All right, so now we are going to be making a flap Actually, this is the back side, so I should have put it on the front. But we're gonna be making a flap that kind of goes like this to flap over the top here, and then we're gonna sew a button here. So you can do that. So let's remove our phone and let's slip stitch to the first stitch, like we're going on to another row. And let me see, how many rows was that? So this was 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, round 16. So now I'm going to go on to round 17. For you, it may be different. Your phone is probably a different size, unless you have the same as me, Moto X. But going on to the next round, we are going to chain one, and we're actually going to be turning our work. So we're looking at the inside of our phone case here. Okay, and we are going to, chain two, sorry. So we chained one already, so chain two, like that. And then we are going to half double crochet in the next six stitches. And this one that we just chained up two in is going to we're going to first start there. So this chain up two doesn't count as a stitch. So just put, insert your hook there, and put a half double crochet in there, like that. And then half double crochet in the next five. So we have six in total. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then, you know, you can make sure if that's centered. If it's not, add an extra one or two or however many you need. Just make sure it's centered in the back. So apparently I needed 7, not 6. So just like that. Then chain up two, one and two, turn your work like this. Now we're looking at them, just half double crochet across. So in this first one that we just chained up two in, make sure you half double crochet in there because that chain up two does not count as a stitch. Okay, so I'm just half double crocheting all the way across for 7 stitches. Okay, then chain up two, one and two. Now we are going to be decreasing a half double crochet decrease over these first two stitches. So yarn over, go into that first stitch, yarn over, pull through, so you have three loops on your hook, go directly into the next stitch, yarn over and pull through, so now you have four loops on your hook, and then yarn over and pull through all four of those. So that's a decrease. And then half double crochet regularly in the next three stitches. 1, 2, and 3. And then it looks like you have two stitches left. So then decrease, a half double crochet decrease over those last two stitches like that. Okay, depending on how many stitches you have across, just make sure that you just crochet across and then till you have two left, and then do a decrease over those last two. Now chain up two, turn your work, and do the same thing as we just did with the last row. So decrease over the first two, then single crochet across till you hit the last two, and then decrease over the last two stitches. Okay. Now at this point, I only have three stitches left. So we're gonna chain up one, or I'm sorry, chain up two. And I am going to half double crochet in the first stitch, chain one, and then half double crochet in the last stitch. Okay? And I might actually make two half double crochets in the last stitch, like that. Okay? So that is our buttonhole here. And so I have a button here. So then this is going to go around that. So you want to make sure the size button you have, you're going to fit it in this buttonhole. You know, if your button is a little bigger, you may have to, instead of just chaining one, you may have to chain two in that space. Okay, and if your button is really tiny, you may not have to chain anything. You can just go do your half double crochet here and not do anything, just skip this stitch and then go into the last one for your last half double crochet. So depending on the size button you have, you know, make sure that your button fits through that hole, okay, before you fasten off. Okay. So then when you want to fasten off, you just chain one. I usually just chain one and cut my yarn and pull all the way through, okay? And then at this point, you can, you know, be finished if you'd like, but I don't like this at all. See this edge here, and this edge here is just really gross. So I am going to change my color. You know, if you didn't want to change your color, you didn't have to fasten off, and you can just crochet around this piece. But I'm changing my color and putting a pop of something else in there. And so I have hot pink. And I'm going to turn it so I'm looking at the outside of my piece, like this. And I'm going to start in this corner down here where the start of the flap is, right here, okay, on the back. And I'm just going to hook my yarn in like that and make a slip stitch. Oh, I'll show you how to do that slowly. So I insert my hook into this stitch. I yarn my yarn over my hook, I pull that through, drop the straggler, and yarn over and pull through, okay? So that's a slip stitch, and you can pull the straggler to make it tight. And also you can chain another one like that, okay? Now, just insert your hook into that same space that we just attached, yarn over and pull that through, and then yarn over and pull through too. So we just created a single crochet. And now we can crochet along the edge of our flap. And I am going to just, you know, insert my hook wherever it fits. Does not matter, you know, where it goes, just as long as it fits along the edge and it's clean, then you're good to go. Okay, and now we're along this edge here. So if you hit corners or anything, you can put two single crochet in the same stitch. That's totally fine, in corners only. And we're just crocheting along here. I am going to be crocheting over my straggler. I had a loose end here, so I'm just going to be crocheting over that to hide it. And I'm coming down the other side. Whoops. The other side of this flap. There we go. Okay, and then I'm going to crochet. I'm not going to fasten off here. I'm going to crochet along the rim of this piece too. So I'll show you how I'm doing that. So now I get to this point here, like that. And let me untangle my yarn as I'm all tangled up for some reason. Oh, gosh, I hate that. I hate when I get into knots. So let me untangle this and I'll be right back. All right, so I untangled my yarn. So now I'm just gonna crochet along the edge of this piece here, this rim. So you can just go in each stitch now. You don't have to, you know, find a spot for it. So I'll just go all the way around this piece. And then we'll come back to the beginning where we attached our yarn. Okay, and what we're going to do is just slip stitch into that first single crochet that we made. slip stitch in there, and then fasten off. And what I usually do is just chain up one, cut my yarn, and pull through, and pull tight. Okay, so I gotta sew in my ends, but if you look, you have your case. So you can end it here and just sew on your button like that. But in mine, I am actually going to be putting a pocket on this front part here, and then my flap is going to cover that pocket as well, because we want to put our credit cards in there as well. I've got all kinds of fancy cards. My fancy library card, I want it to put in here. So we're gonna make a pocket to slip these in, and then our phone will go in this back pocket. Okay, so let's get that started, and we'll move on to the next step. All right, to make the pocket, we are going to be using the same color yarn as our main color, so, and we're going to be making the same stitch. So it's very simple. What we have to do is make a slip knot, again, just like that. All right, and still same size hook, and we need to chain enough that will cover this card, which is 2 inches, a little over 2 inches, but I'm gonna make it 2 inches because it's a very stretchy yarn. So let us chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yep, 7 stitches plus 1, so 8. But we're not going to be, remember, we're not working in that one. Now, in the second chain from the hook and across, we are going to half double crochet. So yarn over, go into the second chain, yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. So that's a half double crochet. So then half double crochet in each chain across. So then we'll have 7, in my case, 7, I guess it would be in all cases because all credit cards are the same size. So, you know, if you want to put your ID in there, your credit cards, those kinds of things, cash can be folded. All right, so there's our 7 stitches. Now chain up 2 and turn, and now we are going to put a regular half double crochet in the first stitch like that, and then in the next stitch we are going to put a front post half double crochet, and then in the next stitch just a regular half double crochet, and then in the next stitch a front post half double crochet, and then the next stitch a regular half double crochet, and then the next stitch a front post, and then in the last stitch a regular half double crochet. Okay, so there you have that. Then chain up 2, 1 and 2. Now, since we are turning this work and we were not turning this work, we have to start using back post half double crochets. Okay, we didn't in this one because we weren't turning our work, but now since we are turning our work, we do. Okay, so on this one, we are going to work around this first stitch here. Basically the one that we chained up 2 in, we're gonna work around this. So we're going from the outside, so there's nothing here. We're just working around it like this. That's a front post. See, Nadia, you're doing it all wrong. We have to go in, okay, so yarn over, go in from the front, so around this, Okay. And then go into that side. Okay, did you see how I did that? So you went, you yarn over, go around to the front like that, then yarn over and pull through. Whoops. Okay, and it twists a little bit, then yarn over and pull through all three. If you can. My tension was a little bit tight. There we go. Okay. Then on this next stitch, so we just went around the first stitch. Then the next stitch is just a regular half double crochet stitch. Okay. Then the next stitch right here is a back post half double crochet. So go yarn over, go in from the back like this, pull through, and then pull through all three. Okay, now this next one is just a regular half double crochet. Then this next one here is a back post half double crochet like that. Then this next one, where is it? Right here is just a regular. Okay? And the next one here is a back post half double crochet. Okay? Then chain up two, turn our work. That's just the chain two, so that's not going to count as anything. So that's how it looks so far. Painless. It was a little difficult, but not bad. Now, we are just repeating row two on this one. So this one, since this one is a front post, or it looks like a front post, which is was a back post because we were working on the other side. So this stitch right here is just a regular half double crochet. Then this stitch here, which is a regular half double crochet, needs to have a front post. So now we're going in from the front around this piece, like this. Okay, so front post, half double crochet. Then the next stitch is just regular. Then the next stitch is a front post. Okay. Then the next stitch is a regular half double crochet. Okay. And the next stitch is a front post. And the very last stitch here is, oops, I'm in the wrong spot. There we go. A regular half double crochet. Then chain up two, turn our work. Now we're working back posts. So you can, work around this chain, or you can go like this, which I found it a little difficult the first time I did it. So go in to the side like this. So pretend this chain up two isn't even here and just go like this. Okay. Oh wait, that's a front post. I'm so sorry. We're going to the back. So yes, we do have to go in from the back like this. So there's no like going around anything. Like with these ones, we would have to go like this. But with this one, we are going like this. Okay, so we're going, you're yarning over, going in and in like this, then yarn over and pull through, okay, and then yarn over and pull through all three loops, okay, then in the next one is just a regular half double crochet, then the next one is a back post, so I'm going in from the back, around the post, and making my half double crochet. Then doing a regular half double crochet in the next stitch, and then doing a back post half double crochet in the next stitch. Okay, then we just did a back post, so now we just do a regular stitch, regular half double crochet, And now onto the last stitch, we're making a back post half double crochet. Then chain up two, turn your work. This is what it looks like so far. So we are about 2 inches. So we need to be, I think it was three and a half. 3.5 inches tall. So just a few more rows. Now we're working on the front here. So regular half double crochet in the first stitch. Front post half double crochet in the next. Then regular half double crochet in the next. Then a front post in the next. Then a regular half double crochet in the next. And then a front post. And then in the last stitch, a regular half double crochet. Okay? Don't worry about these edges looking super gross and ugly. We are going to be crocheting around them. So chain up two, turn your work. It actually looks kind of cool. Like meh, meh, meh. But anyway, this is the hard part. Going in from the back to the front. Yep, we're doing our back post half double crochet. I did that wrong. These back post half double crochets are kind of difficult, so you have to really know what you're doing. Oh, come on. There we go. Okay, there's that one. Then the next stitch is just a regular half double crochet. Then the next stitch is a back post. Then the next stitch is regular. Then the next stitch is a back post. Then the next stitch is regular. And the last stitch is a back post. Okay, so you kind of get it now, so just repeat that until yours is as long as you need it to cover your credit cards, and I will meet you up when we are going to crochet around the edge. Alright, so mine ended up being about 10 rows, and now just chain one, and we are going to be working on the right side where our pattern is, okay, so you can definitely tell which side is the right side and which side is the back side. Our right side has our vertical lines, our pattern stitches that match the front of our cell phone case. The back side has these horizontal lines that are not very attractive and that would not match our pattern on our cell phone case. So stick with this side being upward towards you and chain one, but we are still working on this side. We're not turning anything. And I ended on this side. So I did the front post side, I guess. But now we're just going to single crochet around this piece. So wherever your hook fits, you can single crochet around the edge of this entire piece so that these edges, become straight and not so ugly as they were. And once you crochet around this entire piece, you can fasten off with a very long tail. And we will sew this to our cell phone case and finish our project. All right, so I'm just going to slip stitch to the beginning here like that and then fasten off. So I chain one and cut a long piece of yarn and pull that through. Okay, so now this is what it looks like. And you can decide which side is up and which side is down. I think I like it like this. And, or actually, kind of like it like this. Okay, so you can sew this to the front of your thing, and your card will slip right in there like that. Okay, so I'm going to sew mine. I'll just show you the beginning here. Just yarn your needle, line it up directly under the rim here, and just make sure not to go through all the layers because you don't want to sew your cell phone case shut. So it might be better to have one hand inside of the case like that to kind of guide it. And then just go back and forth through the two layers around the edge like that. And then once you get all the way around to this side, we'll fasten off.
Okay.
All right, so to fasten off, what I usually do is go from to the inside. Okay, so I'm back up to the top here. So I went to the inside, and then I go around a few stitches like that and insert my thumb so that it doesn't tighten, and then I just make a knot like that. And I do that a couple of times just to make sure, and just make sure you're not going through both layers because you don't want to you know, tie off or close your card case area. So just pull that tight, and then we can sew in the straggler inside here, just between a few stitches, and go back. Okay, stretch it out and cut the yarn. So there's your pocket. And it's the same color as the case, so it's kind of like a secret pocket, which is kind of cool. So we can put all of our cards in there, nice and safely. And then our phone in here, just like that. And then this flap will come over the top of that like that. Okay, so we will put this button on right there, but I still feel like this is so plain, and I just sew this in, but I kind of want to make something on the back here, like a little flower or something, so I think that's what I'm going to do. You know, you can sew on your button and be on your way and have a great cell phone case and card case, but follow along on this next step, and I'll show you how to make the backing.
Good.
All right, so I just sewed on this button, and I put my cards in here and my phone in here, so you can see that it's working and looks really good. And I can take my phone out like that. This is the back side so far, and then my cards are in here. And this pocket is quite stretchy, so I mean, if you have, you know, folded bills or more cards than, I mean, I just put four cards in here, so like license and two credit cards and like something else, you know, just showing four cards. But you can put in there, you know, whatever you need, or even a lip gloss or something like that. It's kind of cute. So that's that, and then the button closure like that. So we're going to make the flower part now, so switch over your hook size to the G hook, okay? And for the flower on the back, since my phone is colored with these colors. So you can see my phone has this color in it and the hot pink in there. So my flower is going to be, there's dark green in here, and there's also orange, and then there's some white. So I'm going to use these three colors. So we are doing a three round flower. The middle round, we're going to start from the center and work our way out. So that's going to be the green, then the orange is going to be the second layer, and then the white is going to be the last layer. So, and you can just use scrap yarn for that. So I'm going to insert my phone in here so it's safe, and let's get started on this part. So for this, starting out with the green, and you can make yours all one color if you'd like, or you can make it three different colors, totally up to you. But make a slip knot, and then chain three, so yarn over and pull through, one, two, and three, and then make 12 double crochet, oh, I'm sorry, 11 double crochet in the ring. This chain up two is going to count as a stitch. So 11 double crochet, okay? And a double crochet is yarn over, go into that chain, yarn over and pull through, yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over and pull through two. Okay, so just keep going into that same chain. And we are going to be making 11 of these, and that chain up two, so we chained up three, and we're working in the third chain from the hook, and that chain up two is counted as our first double crochet. And notice I'm working, turning my work, turning it around to make this circle. Okay, so how many do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Three more. 10, 11, and 12. Okay, then find that chain up two. You might have to stretch your work a little bit. There it is, right there. And slip stitch into that. If I can find it. One and two. There we go. It's going to be a little tight. I think my stitching was a little tight there. Okay, so slip stitch. So you pulled through and through. There. Okay, then you can tighten this all. And to fasten off, just chain one and cut your yarn and pull. Okay, so that's our middle. Now changing color to my orange color. Let's see here. Oh, so much yarn, so many tangles. There we go. All right, so for the second round, we are going to, again, start with a slip knot. You don't have to start with a slip knot, but I am going to. And it says to join the second color, which is my orange, with a slip stitch into any of the double crochets. So I am going to start over here, really anywhere, doesn't really matter. And then it says to slip stitch. So just what I did was insert my hook, pull through and through like that. Okay, so now I'm attached, and then we're going to chain one like that, and then we're going to put single crochet two into the same stitch like there. So insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, and yarn over and pull through two. So put two of them in the same stitch. One and two. One, two, in the same stitch. Then single crochet two in each stitch around. So in the next stitch, and I'm going to single crochet over the top of my straggler. Okay, so we're going to put two single crochets in each stitch all the way around. And then we're going to slip stitch to the beginning and fasten off on this color. So at the end of this round, you should have 24 single crochets. So don't forget, you know, that chain two that was in the beginning on this green round. Oopsie, see, I already messed up. Gotta put two single crochets in each stitch. Remember that. So you should have 24 single crochets at the end of this round, so I will meet you back up when I have that. Okay. Alright, so I'm just going to slip stitch to the beginning single crochet here. Okay, then to fasten off, I just chain one and cut my yarn and pull through. Okay, so that was round two. Now going on to round three, and our last round. We are going to use white, or actually in mine it's Aran, so it's off-white. Make a slip knot, and we can attach it to any of the single crochets around. Okay, so make a slip stitch, same how we did for round two, just like that. Then it says to, let's see here, slip stitch. Oh, we just did slip stitch. Okay, so now we have to skip a stitch. So skip this next stitch and put five double crochets into this next stitch here. So five double crochets. So yarn over, go into the stitch, yarn over and pull through, yarn over, pull through, two, yarn over, pull through two. That's one. Go back into that same stitch. Two. Three. Four. And five. Okay. Then we're going to skip this next stitch here and slip stitch into this stitch right there. So insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, and pull through. Okay, then skip this next stitch. Actually, in my case, that's the stitch I just slip stitched into from the last round. So skip that stitch and put five double crochets in the next stitch. And I am going to crochet over the top of my straggler. Very convenient. So put five double crochets in there. And then we're going to skip the next stitch and slip stitch into the next stitch. And then skip the next stitch and then put five double crochet in the next stitch. So skip this one, slip stitch into this one. Then skip this one and put five double crochets into this one. Easy does it. And at the end, you should have six petals, and that should be big enough to fit on the back of our phone case. And so I will just, you know, repeat this pattern all the way around, and I'll meet you back up when I am going to fasten off. All right, so I just made my sixth petal, and we are just back to the beginning here. So let's just slip stitch where we attached our yarn. And to reinforce this, because there's a little bit of a gap there, I am also going to slip stitch to the first stitch as well. Okay, that's a personal preference. Then I chain one to fasten off. I'm going to cut a very long piece and just pull that all the way through. Okay, so there you have your flower motif. Now I do see one thing I don't really like is this hole is open here. So I have my straggler in the back, and I am going to close that. You know, you can do the magic ring starting, and that is no problem. That way you won't have that hole. But I have a straggler here. I can just close that just like that. See how lovely Ned is now. So there's your flower, and that is going to go onto the back of our phone case. You can either sew in all your ends and then sew this on to your phone case, or just put them all in the back here like that and sew that on. So I'm going to sew this onto my phone case, and I'll meet you back up when we are all finished. All right, so I just finished sewing this onto my piece. I just sewed it on very similar to how I sewed on this front pocket here. So I just sewed it back and forth, all the way around, so it's all closed in. And I made mine a little high. You can make yours, you know, if you want it in the middle or lower. It's totally up to you, wherever you want to sew your little flower. But our cell phone cover is complete. So there you have it. So you can open the button here and take out your credit cards or your ID, and your cell phone is in the back. So there you go. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to subscribe to my channel. Make sure you like this video. You know, join my Facebook page and share your work if you made a cell phone cover like this or make this one. Share it on our Facebook page so everybody can see your fabulous work. And make sure to check out all the links in the description of this video. I'll have the pattern link there, and my website as well, where all my crochet videos are at, so you can view all of those. Thank you so much for watching, and happy hooking!